Hi, I'm Andrea from AWS. More and more customers are building products and services connected to the internet, and they're architecting their solutions using AWS cloud technologies. Let's take a look at how a few of them are doing that. WeGot is scaling their IoT platform for water management and sustainability.
I'm assuming it would be a lot of events. How many events are we talking about?
So we are talking about 27 million data points per day, which is what we ingest and process.
Okay, so 27 million events, right? So once these many events of data come, I'm sure scalability is a big requirement here.
Absolutely. So we've already taken care of the scale with respect to the ingestion part, because these lambda scale based on the amount of data coming in. We're really not worried about how many sensors the business adds. The second part of the scale is managing them. Once the data has reached the cloud, how do we manage it so that we don't slow down the ingestion? Which is where the preprocessor comes in. So what the preprocessor does is it reads data from these queues, these are the SQS FIFO queues, and makes an important decision as to what amount of data needs to be really processed. The reason why I say this is a utility like water is not something we use 24/7. So not all data points are warranted to be executed. So the preprocessor takes this decision in real time, looking into the data, and decides what to process and what not to process. Now, how does that do? It works in conjunction with the Elastic Cache, which is a high-speed in-memory Redis database that we use. And once it determines that, hey, this is the amount of water that, the amount of data points that we need to process, those are the only data points that get forwarded to the post-processor for processing. So by making intelligent decisions as to how much we need to process, and by allowing, you know, any amount of data to come in, we essentially have built the architecture to scale for any amount of sensors and any amount of data.
This is like a real example of scalability, right? And looks to be heart of your system. So what percentage of events are really worth, you know, to share to the end users?
In our experience, I would say, you know, about 40% of the time series data that we get is what goes into the final stage of processing.
And how does the end user get the final view of how efficiently are they using water?
Yeah. So once this 40% of data is siloed out, they are further processed and pushed into a post-processor. There are a bunch of jobs that run on an EC2 instance, and they end up getting saved in two data stores. So we've got two purpose-built data stores. One is the Aurora serverless version of MySQL, and the other is DynamoDB. The Aurora serverless version stores a day data, like how much of water was consumed in a particular sensor in a day. What are the alarms? So these are basically daily statistics that get stored. DynamoDB, on the other hand, you know, is something that stores events. So why events and why daily data? We cater to both sources as well as inlets in a society. Sources could be your tanker lorries coming in. Sources could be your bore wells. So there, instead of the amount of water, it's about when did the lorry dump water into the sump, right? When did the bore well start, right? And in conjunction with the Aurora daily data, both of this can be provided via web APIs to our client web portals as well as the mobile apps. So essentially, we have a web layer that interacts between both of this and pushes the data to the end user's consumption points, which is the app and the website.
Our next customer, Spark IoT, has developed a managed private IoT network that transforms the way we work, play, and live for the better.
So we have a number of devices, and you can have many devices that connect using LoRaWAN through to the LoRaWAN gateway. What then happens is it traverses over our Spark 4G network through into the IoT core for LoRaWAN, which is the brains of the operation.
So how does the IoT core help?
It's very helpful in helping to reduce the development time and setting up these quite complicated networks. It also reduces the operational burden. So what it means is we can go from several days of setup or more down to just a couple of hours.
Awesome. So you've told us about the sensors, the gateway, the core. What happens to the data once it gets into the core?
Well, the data is the really interesting thing in IoT. So there's a couple of things that happen. There's a rules engine within the IoT core that we use. But firstly, it is streamed up through Kinesis Firehose and into the S3 bucket. The rules engine then transforms the data and sends it in one of two paths. So along through the Kinesis Firehose and up to our operational dashboards that we use at Spark, or down through the API gateway and out into our customers.
Awesome. So looping back to an earlier point you made, how Spark drives their products based on customer feedback. How is Spark driving business value out of the data that they've got through their system?
Yeah, so we derive value from data in a couple of ways. And with IoT, data is really where the value sits. So firstly, for our operational teams, we're creating a centralized dashboard that our support teams can use to manage the individual accounts. And for our customers, we're creating unique experiences. So by moving the data through into their individual applications, we're able to create unique experiences for each customer that really talk to their own data and insights and their own business and what that business needs.
Let's wrap up with Eden, which is reinventing indoor gardening using AWS IoT Core and Amazon Pinpoint into interactive workflows.
On our garden inside, we're running free RTOS with a variety of Amazon libraries and SDKs inside of the garden. We use it for device provisioning as well as the device shadow service, which sends consistent state across the rest of our architecture, as well as, you know, OTA updates, jobs frameworks, that sort of thing.
Okay, and how do those kind of OTA updates, you know, How do you provide connectivity to AWS?
Yeah, absolutely. So from our garden, we connect directly to IoT Core, and we're using the again the device shadow here to replicate garden state. So, you know, things here, right? We've got water level that comes in. We've got relative humidity. We've got temp. Are all readings, amongst others, that come from sensors on the device. We have a variety of them, two temperatures, you know, relative humidity, water. We have an advanced water sensor there. It's taking electrical connectivity readings through the water, and all that information is being sent up to Amazon IoT Core through the device shadow.
So it sounds like you got a bunch of sensors inside of the garden itself taking these.
Yeah.
And then those get sent through IoT. So I imagine these are processed by Lambda and then sent into Pinpoint. So I imagine that's also the smarts of the garden.
Sure, absolutely. So what's really important about IoT Core for us is the ability to associate a topic rule. So we've got a topic rule here that monitors a MQTT device shadow underneath the scenes is MQTT. And so we've got a topic rule that monitors a very specific queue from MQTT associated with updates and triggers a Lambda for us.
Okay.
That Lambda is all about responding to state changes of interest from the garden. So if the water level, you know, goes down and gets really low, then, you know, we're monitoring that with a topic rule, a Lambda fires, and then it's going to go over to Pinpoint and tell Pinpoint, hey, you know, the owner of this garden, users can have many gardens, of this garden has low water, and so we need to go ahead and reach out to them and let them know that via push notification that they need to do something to address their low water.
We hope you enjoyed this look into some of the ways our customers are using AWS IoT services to build innovative products and solutions. Find out more by watching the full episodes from the links in the description. And keep watching This Is My Architecture.